Good afternoon, teachers. My name is Jagat, and I welcome you all on the behalf of Sri Aurobindo Society. So this is the series where I share with you every day some of the great innovative ideas given by the teachers of different states. So this week we are sharing with you innovative ideas of Sikkim. So this is the book of Sikkim where we are sharing with you all the innovative ideas. Here you will see the sign of Sikkim. So in all the books you will find some signs of that state. So today the case study which I'm going to share with you, that name is self-learning. So today we are going to know that how teachers have implemented such ideas in their school that they have got some benefits in improving attendance, improving learning of student. There are so many various aspects of education. So in today's case study, there are three innovative ideas, and I'll share with you all the name of the teachers also who have given these ideas to us. So now the question comes of a lot many teachers that, sir, you share with us every day that innovative ideas of different state. How I can share my innovative idea with you, and what are the parameters to share these innovative ideas, and what are the conditions to be selected in the Teachers Innovation Award? So I will answer your all the questions, and if you are excited to know about these things, so I'm sharing my website with you, www.ziei.com. So this is our website, and I will share with you all the answers of these questions at the end of the session. And your queries, if you have any question, if you have any query which you want to share with me, you can tell me in the comment box of Facebook, or you can ask me directly on the Zoom app. You will find the link of Zoom app in the Facebook comments. So there you can ask me about your queries, questions, and anything which you have in your mind. So now let's talk about our today's case study, self-learning. So when we talk about the self-learning, there are so many people, there are so many educators, they know the importance of self-learning. So when a teacher is teaching in the class, the moment is very nice, but the point is when the teacher is not available in the class and the students are learning by their own, students are trying new experience to learn something new, students are learning by themselves. So that looks so beautiful. That is achievement of a teacher. The teacher have made those students that much self-dependent that they can learn by themselves only. So let's see and let's understand how teachers have made such innovative ideas so the students in the classroom can understand, they can learn everything by themselves, and when teacher is not even present in the classroom. So the first innovative idea which we have today is corner time. So the innovative idea name is corner time. So corner time, as we all know that there are so many students in our classroom, they love to sit in the corner of the class. And what is the reason behind it? Because they find the teacher will not see us here, or the teacher cannot monitor us what we are doing here. But in this corner time, the teacher is going to monitor everything. Teacher can see everything. Students are going to learn a lot many things, new things when they are sitting in the corner. And all these students will love to sit in the corner, and they will have one learning attitude when they're sitting in the corner. So let's talk about this. So what happens in this and this innovative idea? So before that, I want to talk to you about something self-learning. The experience is my experiences. My experiences are sharing about the self-learning. For an example, let's understand this, what is self-learning and how it works. For an example, there is a teacher in the classroom. So when the teacher is in the class, so all these students love to learn a lot. So teacher is teaching with various ways, and teacher is telling them, teachers are practicing more and more activities in the classroom. But one day what happens, the principal sir calls the teacher and he says that it is an emergency and you have to come in the office right now. So at that time, teacher has only two options. One, that he can be in the class so he can manage all the students. He can, so all the students can be in the discipline. Or the second option is order of the principal that he has to go in his office. So at that time, the teacher chooses to go in the principal's office. When he goes there, so the principal tells the work, and when the meeting is finished, after that, when the teacher goes in the classroom, what teacher sees, that is very much shocking. When teacher sees no student is in discipline, all the students are fighting, some are cracking jokes, some are shouting, some are sitting on the desk, not in the proper manner. At that time, teacher feels so bad that when I was not in my classroom, how my students were behaving, so it means somewhere I'm lacking to build the discipline in my students and the self-learning attitude. So then teacher invented this innovative idea. So what benefit the teacher saw after implementing this innovative idea is self-dependent. So all the students became very much self-dependent. They started learning things. So as we know that this program is it is being spreaded by a lot of ministries, that is Atmanirbhar Bharat. So Atmanirbhar, self-dependent Indians, India. So we are talking about here something like that. So what are the benefits which teachers see? Some else that increase, as we all know that there are so many students, they do not love to come in the school, they feel a little bored. So here the enrollment and the attendance is going to be high when teachers start implementing this innovative idea. So this innovative idea encourages all the students to do such new activities every day in the classroom. And this idea can be implemented in all the classes. And the name of the teacher who has innovated this idea, the name is Bashanti Sharma from South Sikkim. So this is the name of the teacher. So what happens in this? So teacher makes a weekly report. Teacher makes a weekly daily weekly chart. In that, so teacher plans for all these students different activities in the classroom. So what teacher is going to do? Teacher is going to make some activities for the students, so all the students can enjoy the class time. And they, as the innovative idea name is corner time. So how teacher prepares that? Let me show you this. So this is the table, as you see that how teacher makes it. So this one is the table. So teacher makes such kind of table. So let me share with you what is in the table right now. So first, in the first column, teacher writes the day, that Monday to Saturday. This is a weekly based activity. In the second column, teacher writes the table time, that at what time we are going to implement this innovative idea. So for an example, teacher is going to implement this innovative idea 11 to 11:30 in the morning. So when the teacher is going to implement this innovative idea, so teacher will write the time. And the next is corner one. So there are going to be three corners in the classroom, the corner one, corner two, and corner three. All the students are going to sit there. What are these corners? Let's understand that. In the first corner, for an example, teacher writes learning from wrapper corner. So wrapper learning is one of the part of this innovative idea I'll share with you. And in the second column, teacher writes reading corner, and the third one writes artist corner. So like this, in the one and the corner one, teacher writes all the activities of the week, and the corner two and corner three. Corner two and three is going to be the same for whole week. So we are not going to make any changes in the corner two and three. So what happens in this? Once the teacher make it, so there are some activities. Let's understand the activities. So the first activity is reading corner. So reading corner is the first activity. What happens in this? Teacher keeps in that corner stories, storybook or the course book. So as we all know that reading is very, very much important for all the students, all the teachers, all the people who live in the society, community. For reading is a must for everybody. How it helps? So reading is the only way to develop a new point of view, to develop an understanding of conversations. Let me give you one example so you can relate with your life also, that you must have seen somebody. For an example, there is a meeting and there are 20 people. So the one person is there who is speaking a lot, who is sharing his point of view, who is sharing plannings that how things work in the society. And there is other person, when the meeting, the people asked him that what do you think about it? So the person was not even able to speak. So the person was blank. He did not have any point of view at that time. So you must have seen such kind of situations in your life. So if you read book, I guarantee you, you are never going to face such situations when you do not have words to say, when you don't have any situation where you cannot participate. Reading book will help you to build a new image, new confidence in you that you can share your point of view. People will know you because of your point of view, behaviors, and your thoughts. This is how a book reading helps you a lot. So here teacher keeps the book of stories book, because we all know that we all love stories. So if we can build in student this confidence or this habit that they start reading stories book, or the second we can keep there the course book as well. Here the course book like like Hindi book, math, mathematics, English, science, social science, any book we can keep, whatever the student wants to read, he can read there. So this was our first corner, and the second is artist corner. We all know that somehow inside we all want to be artist. When we see somebody that making drawings, making paintings, we all love to see that, and we all want to do that activity in our real life also. We feel that, why can't I make such paintings in my life? Why can't I do such kind of activities in my life? So here what teacher does, so teacher give opportunities to all the students so that they can be also artists in their life. So teacher makes one corner of teacher keeps their crayons and some other colors. So like pencil colors teacher can keep there. So many different colors, pages teacher can keep there. Notebooks, drawing books, teacher keeps there in the artist corner, and the student goes there in the time. And they try to make something new, they try to recreate some new creativity. And they try their best to do something there. So this is how this artist corner works. And the next one is language corner. We all know that how language is very important for all of us. The first language should be perfect, that is our mother tongue. As we know, our mother tongue is Hindi. So we all should be good in that. But when we go to villages, when we go to places, we see that regional language is different. For an example, if I'm the person, I'm going to Chhattisgarh, I will see there the people speaking Chhattisgarhi, Sargujia, such languages. At the same time, if I go to Sikkim, I will see people speaking Nepali or some other languages. So here we see like this. So if I go to Assam, I will see people speaking Assamese. So what teacher does, so teacher wants all these students to learn about different languages. And as we know that business language where the whole world is using this language is English. So the whole world is using English language to communicate with each other. So teacher writes one sentence in that corner in one the regional language on the mother tongue where the language students can understand easily. In the second sentence, teacher writes that the language which teacher wants to teach. For an example, teacher has written in Chhattisgarhi in one sentence, and after that, in the second one, teacher will write in Hindi the same sentence in this Hindi language. In the third one, teacher will write in English. So if teacher wants to teach English in the classroom or make the environment that all the students are learning Hindi, these two languages also all together. So teacher writes these such kind of sentences in different language, and teacher uses two boards, whiteboard and blackboard. So in one board, teacher writes one language, on the second board, teacher writes the second language. So this is how teacher writes this. This is how teacher use this board for the language corner. Teacher can write here the word meanings as well. For an example, teacher is going to teach today one subject or any specific lesson. So teacher can write words from or the word meanings from that lesson. So all the students, when they come in the classroom, they see in that corner that these words are written and these are the meaning of these words. So when the teacher is teaching that lesson, so this will be very easy for the students to understand, because they already have their mind when they came in the class, they read those words. Now they somehow understand the meaning of that whole sentence. So it completely saves the time of teacher also. So the next is Shakespeare Friday. So Shakespeare Friday. So what happens in this? So teacher keep some photos of famous poets or the motivational speakers. Teacher pasted some photos there, and teacher asked all the students to write some poems, read their poems, understanding, define their poems. So teacher gives opportunity to all the in the students to understand them and know about them, and reading about their biographies, what those poets are, what they have done, something good in their life, all these things. So this is how teacher does this Shakespeare Friday. And the next is learning from rappers. So learning from rappers, it is a very we can include a lot of things in this innovative in this part of this innovative idea. So learning through rappers, what happens in this? So for an example, how many of you can read that what is the expiry date of this, what is the best before date, what is the manufactured place, what is the manufactured date in that, and what is the place where this product has been made, what is the origin country there, what is the address of that company, which company is making that. There are a lot of information which we can learn from any rapper from there. For an example, we all know that there are almost 90% rappers which we see in the market are English is written on all the rappers. So here students can read about the English words, colors and angles. So many things can be taught by the learning from rappers, and all the students will come to know. And let me share with you something. There are more than 90% people in the whole the country, when they go to buy medicine, they do not check the expiry date. They just buy it. So this is dangerous. We all know that a lot of people die because of this small laziness, I will say, that they do not read it. So we all should take some precautions when we buy something. We should read that wrapper completely. Is it expired, or should I take it? What are the nutrition? What is the nutrition value? What are the things which are added in that? So this is how teacher teaches in that. So teacher keeps some shampoo bottles, some wrappers, and some things which are available in the house. So teacher keeps there and ask all the students to read about them and share with other students also at the same time. So the next is craft corner. Craft corner, what happens in this? So teacher keeps there some reusable things. So reusable things like bottles can be there, and a used notebook can be there, or any stick can be there, any reusable thing the teacher keeps there. And teacher asks all the students to create something new and make something new, that any art and craft situation which we say. So teacher asks all the students to create that so they can also learn about the craft and things. So this is how teacher does this. And after that teacher, this activity is being done on the daily basis. So teacher does it every day. All the students come in the class and they start doing this. So if we see that in one corner, there are a lot of students are sitting there. So at that time, we can change the corners also of the students. We can, for an example, there are 30 students in the one classroom. So 15 students are going to only one corner. At that time, we can divide the classroom also. We can tell those students to go in different corners to do something different. And after that, once all the students, they come, so teacher asks them to present, show what they have learned, and share with all the students what they have learned today, something new, and what they have made, what rapper they brought from their house that they can explain. So teacher does all this activity like this in the classroom. So all the students, they learn in a very good way. The way they learn, that it improves their learning when they are in the classroom. So this is how teacher implements this innovative idea. Now let's go for our next innovative idea. The name is self-created dictionary. So self-created dictionary is our next innovative idea. So the name of the teacher who has innovated this innovative idea, his name is Raju Sharma from East Sikkim. So Raju Sharma is the sir who has given this innovative idea. And this innovative idea can be implemented in all the classrooms from first to 12th class. As per the level of the student, we can increase the level by seeing all the students. So So what happens in this? So teacher, when he comes in the classroom, teacher sees all the students are sitting. So the topic which teacher teaches in the classroom, so teacher gives all the students 5 to 6 words from that lesson, and teacher asks all the students that once you come tomorrow in the classroom, so I will ask you these words and the meaning of these words. So sometime we have seen this, that the all students did not know the meaning of words. So this is the first way of how teacher does it. So teacher, whatever teacher is teaching, so he gives some words from that. And next day all the students come in the classroom and they start telling that how to, that what are the words, how to use in our daily life, and how we can use these words to write any sentence also in the classroom. And the second, in the second way, teacher asks all the students that which is your favorite subject or which is your favorite game. For an example, teacher have asked that students, what is your favorite game? So one student will, Rahul will tell that my favorite subject is cricket. Sonu will tell my favorite game is football. Or and somebody will say tennis. So everybody will tell different names of that game. So teacher says to those students, the students, every day when you come to the classroom, so you have to bring at least 2 new words related to those games which you have told me, at least 2 words. From the cricket, you are going to learn 2 words. What is off spin, leg spin, outside, inside, stadium, what are the Hindi meanings and how to use these sentences when we are talking to anybody. So like this, so students are also excited because this is their favorite game. They improve their learning. They know about more and more words in the classroom. So this is our teacher implement this innovative idea in the classroom, and all the students learn new words, 4 to 5 words, new words every day. So nobody can guarantee that all the students can remember all the words for a long time, but I guarantee that if they are using these words in their daily life, they're making sentences in the classroom, so they can learn new sentences, they can learn new words, and they are never ever gonna forget these words when they are talking to anybody, when they are sharing their experience with anybody. So after that, the words the students have learned, so they come in the classroom, they write those words. So teacher gives them one specific wall, that on this wall, students, you all are going to paste your word for 1 week. And this is the line which is I'm giving to each individual student, and each individual student is going to write these words here and their meaning. And after that, all the students can see that what student has written, which word. So we all know that all the students are also excited to see what my friend is doing, what my friend has written on the board or on the wall. So all the students can also learn new words in the classroom. After 1 week, what teacher does, so teacher asks all the students to remove those words and start writing some new words for this week, what they are learning. And once they learn it, so teacher reviews also that how these students are implementing these new words in their daily life, how they are learning, how they are using these words every day. So teacher sees what word they have written. So teacher notices each and every student in the classroom. Are they really using these words when they are talking to me, when they're talking to their friends or in this or their family members? So teacher asks everybody. So this is how teacher implements this innovative idea. The name self-created dictionary. So this is how all the students have dictionary also, and students can create one notebook also where they can write their words which they have learned. So they have this dictionary for all the time. For in one season, like in one class, at least they have one notebook which is full of new words which they have learned. Once they see that, they will be able to remember all those words easily. So this is how teacher implement this innovative idea. And I believe that you have loved this innovative idea. And once the schools are open, you can try these innovative ideas implementing in your school. So, and if you are implementing such ideas in your school, any ideas of today, you can share with me your life experience, that how you are implementing these ideas and what are the benefits which you see when you implement any idea, your own idea, and how you can share your innovative idea with us. I will share with you at the end of the session, and I will listen to you also, teachers, that what you want to share with me, any question from these innovative ideas, or any idea which you want to confirm or you want to ask me any question. So now let's go for our last innovative idea. The name is Grammar from News. So Grammar from News. So as we all know that there are English newspapers and Hindi newspapers which we find in the market, and we all know the grammar is very strong there. New words we all can find. We can learn so many new words, new sentence structures, which we can say word buildings. We can make a building of new words by just reading newspaper. And we all know that habit of reading newspaper is very good habit. We are updated. We know the news which is around us. We know about the world, what is happening around the world, and we learn new words also. So this innovative idea can be implemented in upper primary classes. The teacher named who has implemented this innovative idea, the name is Lakshmi Devi Bhatri from East Sikkim. So this is the name of the teacher who has implemented this innovative idea in their classroom. So what happens in this? So teacher comes in the classroom. So teacher has one newspaper. So teacher give one page to one student, that the student, this is your page. And you have to on an average, as we see that one page there will be at least 5 to 6 articles. I'm talking about the minimum, and maximum there can be 14 to 15 articles also on one page. For an example, for round figure, let's take the 6 articles on one page. So teacher gives to one page to one student and tells that you have to read at least one article every day and share with me that what is your experience. What is a new word which you have learned from this page? What was in that article? And what are the things which you have learned? And the grammar, like the student can tell about the noun, pronouns, verbs, adjectives, adverb, conjunctions, and the prepositions. Students can write all these things, and this teacher can explain. Teacher can tell about the one article also after reading that. This is how students, you all students, are going to implement this idea. You are going to read this article in your class, and these are the ways that you can read, and this is how you can write the sentence, and you can find the grammar by the newspaper only. So this innovative idea helps teacher a lot to that the students are updated. They know so many things in the classroom only. They can learn things by implementing new ideas, or they can learn things by reading new articles in the classroom. The students are updated. They know so many new things which are happening in the classroom, and the students. So this is how teacher implement this innovative idea, Grammar from the News. So teacher can also come and read one article every day. So teacher can share with all the students that sir, this is how you read this article and get information, and this is how these are the words which you can use in your daily life. And this is how you can implement such great articles in your life, great knowledge in your life. So teacher can motivate all the students about this innovative idea. So these were the innovative idea, teachers. And I believe that you have loved this innovative idea. If you are watching me later on the Facebook, so you can write your questions and you can ask me any question later on. I will read your comment in tomorrow's session. I'll come back and I'll answer your all the questions. So as I promised you in the starting, that I'll share with you that how you can share your innovative idea with me. So our website, www.ziei.com. So this is our website. There you can go. You will see one pop-up. There will be submit your innovative idea. Just click on that page, and just you can submit your innovative idea. There are 4 parameters which we all need to take care of when we are implementing this innovative idea. Submitting our innovative idea. The first is that your idea should be based on zero investment. As you know that our program name is ZIIEI, Zero Investment Innovation for Education Initiatives. And the second is your idea should be implemented already in the classrooms. So idea the which you are going to share with us, you are implementing that, you are using that idea, that and you have got some benefits also from that. And the third parameter is that your idea should be documented. So you can write that idea, you can share with us in a written form that we can understand, we can read it easily. And the fourth is that the outcome should be fruitful, that you should be learning, the student should be learning, or there should be any benefit of teachers, girls, community, and society. benefit of anybody. So these are the parameters which that you need to take care once you are sharing your innovative idea with us. So these were the innovative ideas, teachers, which I had to share with you. So let's meet tomorrow with different innovative ideas, and I'll come here tomorrow with another case study. There I'll share some another innovative idea. Till then, you have a great day, great learning. Bye bye.